Two superstars, two combat sports, one ring. Conor McGregor and Manny Pacquiao, both fighters' camps have spoken about a 2021 supermatch. But when will it happen? How will it go down? And where is it to take place? We are about to answer those questions and a whole lot more in this video. But before we get started, subscribe below. A master of mental warfare and self-promotion, Conor, the notorious Mystic Mac McGregor, has built his following on extraordinary call-outs, shocking knockouts, and an outrageous persona. Manny Pacquiao, on the other hand, is known for his humble ways, rags-to-riches story, and his three-decade, eight-division championship ascension. But being that both these stars fight in separate sports, how is it that a fight between them came to be discussed? The stir began on September 25th of last year when Conor claimed veteran superstar and Filipino congressman Manny Pacquiao would be the next boxer he faced. Conor had been teasing his return to boxing for a while, but it was Conor's Twitter comment about a potential matchup against Pacquiao that set the media ablaze. Since then, Pacquiao's camp has confirmed the matchup, stating that they are preparing for a fight in 2021.
I think with small adjustments in the prep and an understanding of what that style he's coming at me with now, I think I'd beat him. I really do think I'd beat him.
Media sources state the super fight will undoubtedly take place in the Middle East due to obvious pandemic restrictions, and as of now, it's looking like it will take place. But Conor has an upcoming UFC fight that must go down first. On January 23rd, Conor is set to face off against Dustin Poirier at UFC 257 on UFC's Fight Island. It is Conor's first return to the octagon since defeating Donald Cowboy Cerrone by way of first-round knockout. And in his return against Poirier, Conor's camp says he's in the best shape of his life. But how will Conor shift from UFC to boxing? Why schedule a UFC fight now? Conor's opponent, Dustin Poirier, guessed that Conor had a plan, and this was a guess that Conor only confirmed. Dustin stated that he believed Conor chose him because he is a southpaw. By fighting the esteemed Poirier, Conor is not only solidifying his return as a top UFC contender in the lightweight division, but he's also readying himself for Manny Pacquiao, who happens to be a southpaw as well. But the question remains, is Conor spreading himself too thin, or is he ready for his return to the boxing ring? If you remember, Conor faced off against Floyd Mayweather in 2017. After a huge press tour and unprecedented buildup as the biggest fight in combat sports history, Conor came into the fight weighing almost 20 pounds more than Mayweather. McGregor started strong, and he shocked the world with some of his boxing skills. Ex-trainer and boxing analyst Teddy Atlas had McGregor winning four rounds of the fight, but McGregor, along with every other one of Floyd's opponents, just couldn't seem to finish. McGregor won some battles, but not the war. In the end, Conor gassed out, and Floyd took the fight by a 10-round TKO.
And still undefeated, Floyd Money!
Mayweather admitted that his strategy played out. Floyd let McGregor throw early and waited to attack, but he and many other boxers admitted they were impressed by McGregor's performance. Now, the show was one thing, but the purses, tickets sold, and money made from this fight took it to a whole new level. Even after his loss, McGregor was said to pull in around $130 million. Not bad for a first professional fight between the ropes. Then again, Conor was fighting the best ever, Floyd Mayweather. As far as sales go, this is the second highest grossing fight of all time, falling short only to the long-delayed super match between Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. Ironically, Pacquiao and Conor share a similar defeat, with Pacquiao losing to Mayweather just 2 years prior to McGregor. And Pacquiao struggled in a lot of the same ways as McGregor. Like McGregor, Pacquiao's traps didn't work against Mayweather, and his stiff, rapid attacks were inefficient against Mayweather's defense. It's clear that both Conor and Manny have grown immensely since their losses to Mayweather. But the question is, can McGregor stand up against Pacquiao's aggressive style?
And let me tell you, that was just a quick punch.
Conor is definitely one of the top boxers in the UFC, and his left hand has proven that time and time again. But there is one big difference between Mayweather and Pacquiao. Punches thrown. No, Manny may not be 50-0, but he has delivered some of the most brutal combinations in boxing history. We can guarantee that Manny will not wait for McGregor to gas out. He'll go on the hunt, coming 100 miles per hour with his signature stiff punches and flurry of blows that typically leaves his opponents stunned. Pacquiao's style is relentless. It's a style he's held through over 70 fights. Pacquiao has fallen, and fallen hard. But where McGregor has retired and returned to the UFC, Manny has kept his career going steady. He always manages to pick himself back up and earn another belt. This pattern has been spectacular in recent years. After a controversial loss to Joe Horn, it seemed Pacquiao's career was about over. He had separated from his longtime and legendary trainer Freddie Roach and lost to a fighter that was far below his level. It seemed the old Manny was gone and that he was past his prime, finally failing to age. But with a new era of boxers surfacing, Manny reunited with Roach and returned to his old ways. He was able to make yet another comeback. First, Manny took down Lucas Matisse by TKO, then beat Adrian Broner by a unanimous decision, and in July 2019, he beat an undefeated Keith Thurman by split decision to take the WBA Super Welterweight title. From there, he said to himself, his boxing journey was not over. With Pacquiao back at the forefront of boxing, all the young guns have been calling his name. From Errol Spence to Ryan Garcia, it seems that everybody wants a piece of the legend. We don't know Manny's long-term plans, but one would guess he's heading towards retirement soon and has a handful of fights left, if that. Choosing McGregor as his next opponent could guarantee Pacquiao with record-worthy revenue, and he has stated that his fight purse will be donated to the virus relief in the Philippines for all those who are in need of support. If the money can help, why not? Many experts claim this is an easy grab for Pacquiao, but let's not forget how many times McGregor has been counted out in the past. Early on in his UFC career, Conor lit a fire underneath the franchise and had fans going crazy. But it looked like his glory days were over when McGregor was set to face off against the Brazilian Jose Aldo. No one expected McGregor to win this fight, but McGregor's 13-second knockout made him not just a UFC superstar, but a sports superstar, and eventually a household name. How does Conor fit into the boxing spectrum? Sure, his boxing skills are no joke, but will his octagon skills translate into the boxing ring? Did his experience against Mayweather shape him into a better boxer? How will he do against a more aggressive fighter? Is he in as good a shape as his camp claims? And what about Manny Pacquiao? He has the obvious advantage in the ring, but does he still have gas left in the tank? Can he take on another elite athlete in his prime, or will the outcome of this fight shock the world once again? I guess we'll have to wait to find out.